after 7 years, we had to move out of the Goethe Institute in Manara, which was a landmark in the cultural landscape of Beirut. So we had this, we found this very nice building on a super nice location in the heart of Beirut, in Jemaise, but access to downtown, but also to Ashrafieh, and coming from the highway from Tripoli or from the south, so it's very accessible. At the beginning, we knew we want to change this place, to make it more lively, to make it a place for communication, for exchange, for creation. But we didn't know how it could look like design-wise. And then we partnered with the Architects for Change, and we sat together and said, okay, how can we define what we want at the end? And we said, okay, it would be good. What are our main target groups or who we are addressing? And then we said it would be very good if we do like small consultation workshops. And we defined three main groups. One of them were, of course, our students. So we were running a consultation workshop. They were interviewing them, trying to understand their needs, our language students. And they, of course, they took note of it, etc. The second group is our colleagues, of course, because I mean they are spending more than 8 to 10 hours a day in the institute, and we consulted them, or the Architects for Change, asked them, what are your needs and what kind of working environment you would like to spend like 8, 10 hours a day, because I think this is at the end also very important, because they are transporting our image outside. So this was the second group. And then the third group was, and this is reflecting very much our working approach, we consulted our partners. We asked them, from your point of view, how do you see the Goethe Institute? How should the institute look like? And yeah, and all the information and the advices we got were pooled by the Architects for Change, and based on this information and consultation, they created this space, of course, in close cooperation with us. Yeah, there are many new features in the new building. I start on the ground floor. So we have a welcoming reception. It's very lightful. We have a completely new light concept. Then we have a library, a modern library with international books, but also, of course, books to study German. Then we have design furniture to make it a lively, inviting place. Then we invested a lot as well in flowers or in plants, let's say, to make it a comfortable, organic, cozy zone. Then we have a cafeteria, for example. So this is also something that is very new. We have an elevator, of course, which brings you on the first floor. What do we have on the first floor? There we have 4 classrooms in total. We had our old classrooms, but this was only a temporary solution because we were just waiting until the moment we are renovating and refurbishing our new classrooms. And I'm absolutely highly convinced about the idea that a room is affecting your learning success. Because if you have a clear structure, if you have very good equipped classrooms with, for example, smart boards or iPads, etc., with access to internet, you can more interactively learn. You know, we had super good trained teachers, but we were teaching in classrooms like in the 60s, let's say. And this was a contradiction, and that's why we pushed and put a lot of efforts on it to move in this new building, and that this is like more harmonized, let's say, the external environment with the teaching methods. And then on the second floor, this is the office and administration place. I mean, this was okay, but it could have been better. And I think after the renovation, we came very closely to a status which we wanted to have. The renovation was very exciting moment, because we I saw there's some progress, so we're going to have this new space after this 7 years of temporary use, etc. But in practice, of course, this is very challenging to follow up a construction. But at the end, I came out really with a very, very positive, with a very positive feeling. And also for myself, it was very interesting. The first time that I was like following on something like that, you get a new product, or in this case, a new Goethe-Institut. And in this case, I'm super proud of my team. We were working for almost 1 year on a construction, and the last 4 months before we finished it, finally, we were even having masks, for example, because the dust and the noise, etc., was so strong. And for me, this was also internally, it was a super good learning experience, and it made us as a strong, the entire colleagues, it made us like, it formed us, I would say, to a really big team, because we were continue working during the construction site. And for this, I'm not only proud, but also super, super grateful for this, making this experience. Everybody made it for his own project, and everybody was involved, starting at the reception, at the cleaning person, the housekeepers, for example, but also our teachers and the administration especially, but also our colleagues from the library or from the cultural program. And finally, and with all this commitment and this contribution, here we are. So end of the construction project is the beginning of our real work. So now it's really we're putting, after making this possible with all these efforts and contributions from the entire team, now it's our task to make this a real lively place. And for this, we invite everyone who is interested in cultural exchange and educational themes, but also in learning language, is invited to come to our institute, make it your own place.